My name's Mark Reynolds. I grow oysters and clams. We have an aquaculture company here in Baja California. I think from most outsiders that I know, they think that we've been mad. They think that we should have given up about 8 years ago. I think most people don't understand how we're still standing, if you like. But I think we've almost come through that now, and I think that they feel there's a certain level of determination and justice. We will not give up. So I hope that they're just trying to be kind to us and go, well, you need a break. Part of the great thing about doing aquaculture and mollusk farming is that you're doing something which is sustainable. It's good for the environment. It's good for, in so many different ways, for the world and its resources. One of the disadvantages of doing mollusk farming is a lot of the places where you need to do that for the good of the biology of the species is they are in isolated, remote areas which are not so easy to live in. Places where possibly there isn't any electricity or water or people or education, or I could go on. Most finfish and crustacean farming operate in tanks or within certain raceway systems, and they are, generally speaking, not very sustainable or environmentally friendly. Mollusks are particularly environmentally friendly because they work and they live and they feed off microalgae, which is naturally available in the water. Mother Nature is something which I like to be involved with. But one thing when I started the project was I didn't understand Mother Nature very well, and I underestimated Mother Nature. And Mother Nature has taught me a great deal as to what I can expect, to respect her, to try to understand what she gives me and be grateful for it. And when she wants to rap me over the knuckles for something I've done wrong, to accept that gracefully and change. So
we had visions that it would be easy. We thought that you got a shellfish, you have your seed, you plant it in the water, and 2 years later you take it out and you start making money and things grow from there. It's not quite that simple. There are many, many factors which come into play, especially being part of the environment, being part of nature, where you're controlled by temperature, by climate, by swings of growth and mortality. And it's been a learning curve. It's been a long road. Yeah, Baja California is a very long coastline. It's no industry, little agriculture which affects the coast. The water is cool, coming from the Alaska, California current. Food and productivity is good. And all of these brought together is a combination which is just ideal for the production of oysters. One of the limiting factors is that there aren't that many bays which give protection to farms and the culture methods which we use. Having said that, we have established ourselves in two bays, and which is sufficient for us. Most of the oysters that you have on your plate at the end of the day will have taken between 18 to 24 months to get there. We start out at the beginning spawning the oysters, producing the larvae, which is a swimming stage. That then changes to seed, which is a non-mobile stage, which fixes onto something. And then we plant the seed out onto the farm, and it goes through a succession of bags, meshes, boxes, holding it as it grows. And about 18 months later, it'll end up on the plate. You would imagine that the most delicate stages are the larvae and seed stage, and that is right. However, mortality can occur on the farms at any time. If there's a large change in temperature, hot weather during the summer, And so you have to be careful all the time. You have to make sure that the densities are right, that the equipment's kept clean, that the flows are right. In the hatchery, we have to make sure that the food is clean, it gets to the animals at the right density, and it takes a lot of care. And the people who work these systems have to understand that one slip up for 1 minute of the day can mean that millions of these animals will die in the hatchery.
Oysters, like any type of mollusks, are completely susceptible to their environment, to their water. They're very, very sensitive. If the water isn't of the right quality in terms of temperature, in terms of oxygen, in terms of food, then those oysters or clams, they won't grow, or more severely, they will die. So it's absolutely critical to have the right waters with the right conditions, with the right flows, and that means locating in a place which for us is the garden of all mollusk farms, which is Baja California on the Pacific coast.
Well, we're moving from really a production and wholesale to distributors into where we're going to be meeting the public eye to eye, selling our product directly to the public, and that would be interesting. We take pride in the fact that we have systems which enable us to get the oyster out of the water and into refrigeration packed as quickly as it can be done.
It's time, it's temperature, it's handling, it's a number of different things. The packing plant is really a control for the health department to make sure that the product which is going out to the marketplace comes from a reliable source, that it's packaged in a way that will ensure that from the source to the final user, there will be no contamination, that product is as safe as it can be for the final consumer. That is the function of the packing plant. Yeah, the journey has been a long journey. If we look back, there's been a lot that's gone along the way, and we can look to the future as well. I think there are two things which help us in our journey. One is that we try to live the day to day. We try to do our best every day, and we try not to reflect on the past or on the future, but to enjoy the moment. And the moment at the moment is the opening of the Jolly Oyster. This is what it's all about. It's going to be fun. And the second thing which helps me particularly is I've got a dreadful memory, so I can't remember all the dreadful things that have happened along the way. Local as defined by FDA is 400 miles. So really we're looking between where we are here in Baja California and really the central coast in California. We approached the California State Parks. They invited us to go to Ventura. We started dealing with some of the personalities and the authorities in Ventura. They've all been extremely helpful. It just feels very right. I think it's something that we can bring something new to Ventura and add value as well. To the wines, to the tourism generally, to the beach, we're a good fit. I don't think I'm nervous, but I'm extremely excited. This is the culmination of so much of 15 years of dreaming, and it feels that finally, after all that we've done, that this is really beginning to make sense. The Jolly Oyster for us in getting to the local market and selling directly and having that interaction between the producer and the buyer, that's what it's all about. It's about bringing our team together with you, and it's just a perfect moment. It's fantastic.